Prie Utenos Juventus ekipos šiame sezone prisijungęs amerikietis Jamaras Diksas jau spėjo įtvirtinti lyderio savybes ir sulaukti didelių Utenos aistruolių simpatijų. Pats 28 metų krepšininkas džiaugiasi sulaukęs gero pasiūlymo ir pasirinkęs Lietuvos klubą.
Utena wanted to play in the Lithuanian league. It's a very competitive league, a very tough league, and Utena was a team that offered me a decent contract, and I wanted to play in Champions League or a chance to play in Champions League and do something special here.
Prieš atvykdamas apie Lietuvą amerikietis nieko nežinojo, tačiau buvo girdėjęs apie garsiausią mūsų šalies krepšinio asmenybę. Krepšininkas tikina, kad Lietuvoje jam patinka, bei jau įprato gyventi mažame Utenos mieste.
No, nothing at all. Maybe a little bit about Sabonis, Arvydas Sabonis, but besides that, I knew about the basketball teams, you know, Rytas and Žalgiris and Neptūnas, but about anything in Lithuania, nothing at all. Utena is a very small city. But I'm getting used to it. I've been here a month now, so it's okay. But Lithuania is a nice country. I like Vilnius a lot. I've been a few times and Kaunas, and I haven't been to the seaside yet or anything. So hopefully I get to see some of that stuff.
2011 metais savo pavardės NBA naujokų biržoje neišgirdęs gynėjas legionieriaus karjerą pradėjo antroje Vokietijos lygoje, o po to rungtyniavo Kipro, Kosovo, Latvijos, Lenkijos bei Rumunijos klubuose. Būtent Kosove krepšininkas patyrė pačių netikėčiausių nuotykių, o labiausiai įstrigusią istoriją pasidalijo ir su LKL televizijos žiūrovais.
Kosovo is very exotic. That's a good word to use. It's different, you know. They gave me an opportunity to come there for a month to help a team out, and it was, let's just say exotic is a good word. I mean, I had a good time there, but it's not for everybody. It's not a place where a lot of people would like to go. There was a game we played in the cup final, and we're playing in the game, and throughout the middle of the game, there's security guards everywhere, and then suddenly fans break in, you know, break the door down. And I look and I think the police are gonna stop it, but they actually beat up the police and threw chairs on the court and fireworks and flames, and we had to stop the game. And that was one of my first or second experiences, and I was like, wow, people just beat up the police over here. So that's what I saw. It was pretty strange.
Ne vienoje egzotiškoje šalyje rungtynėvęs Diksas, jie sugrįžta ir per atostogas, kur aplanko draugus bei ilsisi.
I played a lot of places, and I do that on purpose because I like to see other parts of the world and different people, different cultures. So Cyprus I like to go back to a lot, in Greece, just the Mediterranean area, because the weather obviously is nice mostly all year round and stuff like that. But also like to travel to Germany and Italy. I have a lot of friends who play in other countries, so just for vacation I like to go visit my friends all throughout.
Aukščiausiose Europos turnyruose iki šiol nerungtynėvęs Diksas šį sezoną savo jėgas išbando čempionų lygoje. Nors ir turi svajonę ateityje rungtyniauti NBA, krepšininkas stengiasi džiaugtis šią dieną.
I think every American grows up wants to play in the NBA, but if the opportunity is not there, I mean, I'm lucky and I'm blessed to be able to travel the world and play in so many different countries. So, you know, you want to keep taking steps up. So, I mean, the ultimate goal is just to keep getting better, and wherever it takes me to the next level.
Užsibrėžtų karjeros tikslų Juventus žaidėjas neturi ir stengiasi mėgautis kiekvieną dieną, kai gali žaisti krepšinį ir tobulėti.
Career peak? Oh, let's see. Just happy to me when I play basketball. I like, you know, it's not about, you know, numbers or, you know, I want to win championships or something, but I really enjoy, you know, meeting people and traveling the world and doing this as a career. So peak, I just want to keep going. I mean, really no peak. Hopefully when I start going down, then I'll be done.
Nors dabar krepšinio idealų amerikietis neturi, tačiau vaikystėje norėjo ilgų plaukų, gausybės tatuiruočių ir būti panašus į savo dievuką.
Growing up as a kid, it was a guy in America, his name was Allen Iverson. For some reason, growing up, I wanted to be like him, you know. He had long hair, I wanted to get tattoos all over, I wanted to be like Iverson. Now that I'm older, it's not that, but I would say growing up, that was my basketball. Now, I don't have a basketball idol. I mean, I enjoy what I do, and it's all about, you know, my family and me, so that's the good thing about it.
Diksas save apibūdina kaip linksmą ir atsipalaidavusį žmogų. Linksmai laiką mėgstantis leisti amerikietis, sezono metu laikosi režimo, tačiau neslėpia mėgstantis pašokti vakarėliuose.
Laid back, relaxed kind of guy. I like to have fun. I like to enjoy. Like I said, I like life. I like to smile, dance, you know, have a good time. Because if you don't have a good time, there's no point of doing what you do, you know. So that's why I like basketball, because I can show out and have a good time.
Daugelis amerikiečių didelį dėmesį skiria religijai. Neišimtis ir Utenos klubo įžaidėjas.
Growing up, my family was really religious. I wouldn't say that I'm, you know, strict religious like in the church every day, but I have faith and, you know, and I believe in God and I have religious background. So that's what I would say.
Laisvų nuo treniruočių metu Diksas stengiasi geriau pažinti mūsų šalį ir aplankyti didžiuosius miestus. Radęs laisvo laiko, krepšininkas taip pat stengiasi pasikalbėti su už Atlanto likusia šeima bei draugais.
When I'm not practicing, trying to go to a major city, try to go to Vilnius, try to do something. You know, when you're in Utena, it's not much to do. But also, I like to talk to my family. You know, I call my brothers and my sisters, or my family back home, or my friends. You know, I like to read a lot. You know, now that I'm getting older, I can't do so much of the partying or anything like that. So I just, you know, relax, talk to family, maybe watch a movie, read a book, something like that.
Diksas pasižymi kiek krepšininkams nebūdingų muzikinių skonių, dėl kurio susilaukia komentarų ir tarp komandos draugų. Labiausiai atsipalaiduoti iš žaidėjų padeda klasikinė muzika.
I actually listen to like, it's called like R&B, it's kind of slower music, or I also listen to, it's strange, but my teammates make fun of me, I listen to classical, like the symphony, like Beethoven and stuff like that. I think it like relaxes me, allows my mind to stay clear, you know, I don't need all the rap or the shooting or gang stuff, so I just listen to classical music.
Follow LKL on Instagram.